press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello children, how are you? All are good? So today I am here with you with the new lesson. It's not a lesson, it's a poem. But in the poem, we call this as a lesson, the geography lesson. So in the last, from your main textbook, from a honeydew, so you had seen that about the tsunami. How the tsunami hit to the some of the oceans and also the islands. So it has given a drastic changes to the earth and it leads to the destructions, is it? And a lot of people have killed. So that is about the tsunami. But today I am going to introduce you about the geography lesson. So you have a question, why this miss is doing English subject, why she is saying about the geography lesson from a social science? Okay, so here the poet, the name of the poet is Zulfikar Ghosh. So he says here that how the earth looks like. So when he sat in a plane and he looked down, when he looked down, when he goes higher and higher, the earth is changing. Okay, when he goes higher and higher. So it gives a geography about the earth. Okay, so the distance, the miles, okay, and then the earth is round. It tells about the geography of the earth, how the earth is looks. So what is its location? What is its kind of a features? Okay, so we see that in English subject and it is also in the poem. So we are going to read about the geography lesson, means the poem name, the geography lesson. Okay, so I told you when the poet he was in a aeroplane, when he looked down from the aeroplane and he goes higher and higher, the earth is changing its physical features. Okay, so let's see that what are the physical features. And in the last paragraph of this poem, here the poet has some question where he doesn't understand that question. So why the world is like this? Okay, so let's see. So what is his intention? So what is his, the thing is to understand that. So what is this geography lesson? A poem. Okay, so let's see here. Okay, before I'm going to move here, let me introduce about the poet. So the poet Zulfikar Ghosh, he was born on 13th March in Sialkot, Pakistan. He belongs to Pakistan, but later he became a citizen of USA in 2004. Okay, he shifted to USA in 2004. And he was a novelist. He is a novelist, poet and essayist. Okay, so he writes so many novels. Then he is a poet and also essayist. His first novel called The Contradictions. His first novel is The Contradictions, which was established, which is published in the year 1966. So this novel, The Contradiction, it says about the difference between the Western and Eastern attitudes, okay, and also the way of life, how they are living. So this is about the poet. So let's see about the poem, okay. So guys, what I said about the poet, so how he was, when he was in a plane and he is going higher and higher, so he, when he looks down, so earth is changing its features, the physical features, okay. So then he is going to say that, and this is also called a theme, okay, the theme of the poem. And here I am going to say about some few lines about the poem. Can you imagine what your city would look like if you saw it from 10,000 feet above the ground, neatly planned and perfect in proportion, like a geometric design? It would strike you as something very different from what it actually is while you are in the thick of it. Here is a poet's descriptions of just such a weave of a city and some questions that come to his mind. Okay, I told you this. So when we imagine, when we are in a plane, when we go higher, so nearly to the 10,000 feet, okay, so when we go to the up in the sky, so how the earth looks like? the city which we see here means unplanned manner. So when we go to the higher in the sky, so how we look, it looks like a, it has well planned. So it looks like a geometric design. So when you are when you draw the geometrical figures, so how you are measuring in exact centimeters, you draw some of the lines in an exact line. Okay, like that the earth looks, the city looks, the cities and towns looks like this. Okay, so now the poet has seen that kind of a the scene, okay, the view from the sky. And also it's something give a very different word. It actually is while you are in a thick of it. And here the poet description, so he is describing about that location, how he has seen the earth, okay, when he is in a plane. And also he has some questions in his mind. So let's see, so what are the questions he has in his mind? Okay, so first I'm going to read the poem. Okay, then when the jet sprang into the sky, it was clear why the city had developed the way it had. Seeing it scaled 6 inches to the mile, there seemed an inevitability about what on ground had looked haphazard, unplanned and without style. When the jet sprang into the sky, when the jet reached 10,000 feet, it was clear why the country had cities, where the rivers ran and why the valleys were populated. The logic of geography, that land and water attracted man, was clearly delineated. When the jet reached 10,000 feet, when the jet rose 6 miles high, it was clear the earth was round and that it had more sea than land. But it was difficult to understand that the men on the earth found causes to hate each other, to build walls across cities and to kill. From the height, it was not clear why. Okay, so this is the poem. So here, in the first paragraph, the poet says, he describes about the geographical feature of the earth when he is on a plane. Okay, so I'm going to explain you line by line, so you have to understand it. Okay, so keep the textbook in your hand and keep a pencil and write down the meanings. If when I'm saying about the meanings, the new words meanings, so you have to write down them. When the jet sprang into the sky, sprang means flew. Okay, fly, present tense verb, then flew is the past tense verb. Okay, fly, flew. When the jet flew into the sky, so the jet has take off to fly to the sky, it was clear why the city, so the city is looks like very clearly. Okay, how had developed the way it had, the city has developed the way it looks like. Okay, so when he was in a jet, he not went far away from the earth, still he is in a near the earth. Okay, when the poet, he is in a plane, aeroplane, so he is little bit higher to the earth. So he looks that the city is, it and how it has developed, the city looks like that. Seeing it scale 6 inches to the mile, seeing it, so he has seen from the high that it was measured in a 6 inches to the miles. It has orderly divided the lines, then the streets and the roads, everything it is divided in a, according to the plan of the map of the city. Okay, he says here, there seemed an inevitability. So when we seeing that the city is looks like a plan, okay, and it is measured, when so it has designed according to the measurement of the construction of the roads and the street. So there seemed an inevitability. Inevitability means that cannot be avoided. Okay, so where the city has constructed in a measurement, in a proper manner, with a well-planned manner, according to the map, so that should not be avoided. Okay, then about what on ground had looked haphazard. But when the poet, he is in ground, when the poet is on the earth, now he is on a plane. So when he looks from the sky, he is not went more high, so he just in a little higher. So there he looks, the city looks in a well-planned, which is measured in a properly, okay, according to the geometrical structure, according to the map of the geography, okay. But when he was in a ground, ground means on the, when he is in a city, it had looked haphazard. Haphazard means without plan or order. The city looks like a unordered way, okay. So usually you can imagine the city. If you are in this city, means we are in a city now, so when you observed it, if you go somewhere like a market, if you go from the hotels or anywhere, you just go it in a stadium or anywhere, you just move to the city. So it looks like an unplanned manner, okay. So here haphazard means without plan or order. It looks like that, so city has in an unplanned manner, or it is in a, it is not in an order manner. Okay, so when we are in a ground, ground means on the earth, unplanned and without style. So when we are in a city, in the market, in the city, inside the city, so it looks like it has an unplanned manner and there is no style here. Okay, it is not made up with any designs. There is no designs of the construction of the roads and also the proper order of the buildings, then the streets, the lanes. So whatever the parks, museums, every whatever you takes here, it looks from the ground, it looks like a unplanned. Okay, so the poet says here, when he is in a sky, means when he is in a plane, the city is described in a according to the geographical manner, according to the planned way. Okay, so everything, it is a planned in order. But when he is in a ground, so it looks like that there is no plan and there is no order in the manner. Okay, so it seems like that. So it is called as a haphazard and inevitability. So there are new meanings here. Already here the meaning given there. I told you the sprang meaning is flew. So write down the sprang meaning is the flew. When the jet sprang into the sky, the same word is, the same line is repeating in the last in the stanza first. Okay, when the jet sprang into the sky, so he has looking the city like this, okay, so which is in a planned way, which is measured, each and every streets and roads and the lanes, everything, it is constructed in a planned way and it is measured with the scales and inches, okay, so like it is. Then, so I hope that you have understood about the first stanza. So let's see about the second stanza. When the jet reached 10,000 feet, so when the jet moved to more higher to the sky, okay, more higher means 10,000 feet, okay, so jet was moved to, it goes to 10,000 feet above the earth. So what it looks, it was clear why the country, okay, so in the first stanza he described about the city, then in the second stanza he described about the country. So when he moved to the more higher, he went higher and higher, and that the what called the height of the ground to the sky is 10,000 miles. He went from the earth. So the country looks like, how the country looks like, let's see here. Had cities where the rivers ran and why the valleys were populated. He sees there, he looks there from the more higher, that the country, it looks like a lot of cities which is made up of, okay, the country, it is constructed with a lot of cities and there are rivers which is, and the valleys also. So now he understood that where the rivers and valleys are there, so there the there are a the population is going to be stay there, okay. So why the population is more in the river valleys and all rivers and all near the valleys, because the people want the river, because for the irrigation, because for the agriculture. So that's why the poet understand here, so when he moved to the more higher, so the country looks like, okay, so there are so many cities and the cities are built near the rivers and also the valleys. There only the cities had constructed, the cities are built. Okay, so he says here, and now he is just saying that why the valleys were populated. Why the valleys? So valleys, near the valleys, so why the people are living there? Okay, so he understood now, because the water is very, it's necessary for the people to stay. So wherever the rivers and valleys the people got, so they are going to be living there. Who? The people. The logic of geography. So this is called as a logic of geography. Here is the logic. So what is the logic? So the population means the people are living near the rivers and valley because for the sake of water. So where the water is available, okay, for the people, so there the cities and also the towns are in a the populated. It had the areas like rivers and valleys are populated because of the cities. Okay, then that land and water attracted man was clearly delineated. So that land and water are attracted to the man. I told you, the people are attracted to the water and land. So why they want land? Why? Means it is not saying about the present cities. So when the cities were built in the ancient period and in the medieval period, okay, so they have, they want the place which is near to the rivers and also the valleys. So why they want the rivers and valleys? And also because the man is attracted to the water and also land. The land, it is useful for the agriculture, and water, which is provide a source for the agriculture. It becomes a source for the agriculture, okay, because to get a good crops, and where the people are going to live there. So the man is attracted to the water and also the land. So this is called the logic of geography. Okay, so it is come in a geography. It is not only about simply the people went and lived somewhere, okay, according to their wish. No, so it is the mind thinking ability. So where the water and land is properly available, it's a good enough for the man. So there they are dwelling. Okay, so this is when the jet reached 10,000 feet. Here the new word called delineated. Delineated means shown. Okay, so was clearly shown. So here the question for the man, and the man have attract. So sorry, the man had attracted to water and land. Okay, so why it is? Because it has can we can understand it more clearly. Okay, so it was shown when the jet reached on. When the jet reached 10,000 feet. So the line repeats again in the second stanza. Whatever present in the first line of the second stanza, again it is repeating in the. In the last stanza. So when the jet reached the 10,000 feet, okay, so when the jet goes higher and higher, the country looks like there are a lot of cities which were built. And why the man has attracted to the water and land? So why they selected the place which is near to the rivers and valleys? Okay, so this is about the second stanza. Let's see about the last stanza, that is third stanza. When the jet rose 6 miles high, okay, so again the jet has went more higher, that is 6 miles high, okay, it was clear the earth was round. So for the poet, it is clearly stated that he has proved. So that has proved that the earth is round. Okay, then and it had more sea than land. Okay, so from the higher place, he could see that the earth is a round, and also the water means you know that the water is consist of on our earth, the water is consist of 70%, and the land which is consisting of 30%. Okay, so some percentage is there, but I am giving a rough sketch, the rough percentage of the water and the land. So that is clearly it looks from the higher. To whom? To the poet. The poet looks from the higher that the earth is round and the more water than the land. Okay, the percentage of the water is 70% and the land percentage is 30%. Okay, so that is more water than the land. That is called more sea than the land. We can see the more sea, more oceans than the land. So he could see clearly, who? The poet. But here he says, but it was difficult to understand. So something it is very difficult to understand. So what is that? I told you in the beginning. So he is describing the physical feature of the earth. Okay. So then later he has some doubt, some question in his mind. So what is the question? Now here is the question. He could never understand. It is difficult to understand that. So what is that one? That the men on the earth found causes to hate each other. Okay. That is the men on the earth, the people on the earth. Okay, so they found, so they are having the causes of hatredness to the each other. So why this people, means why the people on the earth, they are having the reasons for the hatredness. Okay, so you never understand that question. To build walls across the cities and to kill. He's saying about the boundaries. Okay, to build across the, to build walls across the cities and to kill. He's saying here, the poet saying about the walls are not constructed around the cities. It is constructed means the boundaries. So where we found? So in the countries, okay? The countries has the country have the boundaries and there is a limit. So that should not cross. You can see it. So there is always the cold war between the Pakistan and India. And the India and also China. Because so they are acquiring the land, they want more land and they wanted to get over the country. Okay, they have to be rule over that country and particular places. So always that intention. So poet is having the question, why these people are need the boundaries, why the people are having hatredness to each other. Okay, so you never understand the question. Although the earth is looks like the round and the water is more than the land, the sea is more than the land. Okay, so the cities are constructed in a well-planned manner, which is looks in a geometric design. Okay, so then why the people are having the hatredness and why they have constructed the boundaries, they have built the walls, it means about they have constructed the boundaries in the countries, in the states. Okay, because there is no, when the earth was formed, so there is no division, there is no divided. So take this land, these people, take this continent to Europe country, take this land to the Asian continent. Okay, divide the earth, has the earth has divided this much of land to those people and these much of land to that people. No, the people are divided. The people are divided like this. It's not about the present situation or present problems. It goes on from, it is went on from so many years. Okay, so it is continuous to the next generations also. So he has the question, and that question, what the question the poet has, it never, he never get the answer for that, because it was went on from the so many years, still it is there, and the next generation also it has following the hatredness, the wars, the battles. Okay, so why these things are there? The main thing is the human kindness, the human loving nature to each other. Okay, so we have all our brotherhood. It's not about only the text, it's not about only the writing or speaking when we are in having a good speech. So that should have to be follow it. How we should follow? It's related to all the people and all the ruler who are ruling the countries. Okay, so when they are followed, then only we can live our country, we live in this country peacefully, in anywhere of the world, peacefully. Okay, so this is the intention of the poet. He wanted to tell to us that, so although the earth is round, so the earth has made such a good geographical structure, but why the people are divided the countries? Why the people are divided the cities? Okay, so he has the question. This is, from that height, it was not clear why. So from that height, he says here, that at the last he asks the question. From that height, he has the question. It is not clear that it is. He has not got an answer that why the countries has the boundaries. Country has the boundaries. Okay. So why it is divided? Why the places are divided? Okay. So this is about the poet and also the poem. I hope that all are enjoyed it. Is it? So here the poet says we should understand others. Okay. So how we are remove our hatredness among ourselves, amongst to other people. So main thing is the hatredness. So when we remove our hatredness from our heart, from our mind, so then only it's possible. So we can live our life peacefully, okay, by loving each other. So this is his intention. Whose intention? The poet's intention. So he's giving a questions to us to understand that, okay, to understand the. So what is the intention of the life to live? Okay. So what is the basic thing of a life to live here? Because further, not a hatredness, not the wars and battle. It's about a love. It's about a kind. Okay, and showing the sympathy to the other people. So this is about the poem. I hope that all are understand about this poem very well. It's not that much difficult to not to understand. Is it? It has written in a simple language, a simple words, which is easy to understand. So I have told you which are the difficult words are given here. I have told you the meanings here. So with throughout the meanings, so daily you should have to be practice that meanings with your construct with your own sentences. Okay, so like that you can improve this language. So this is about. So now here there is a poetic device. So they have the poet has followed some the rules, the techniques to construct a poem. Okay, so that is called as a poetic device. So let's see what is a poetic device here. So here there is a word called refrain. So what it is? Word called refrain. In the first stanza, you can observe here the first line, that is when the jet sprang into the sky, and the same line is followed in the last line of the stanza first. Is it? It has repeated in the last line of the stanza first, that is when the jet sprang into the sky. So that two lines are called as a refrain. Okay, so in the first stanza, the first line repeats in the last stanza, the last line of the first stanza. So those two lines are called as a refrain, and same thing it is followed in the second stanza also. Okay, when the jet reached 10,000 feet, and same line it is repeated in the second stanza, that is when the jet reached 10,000 feet. Okay, so here these lines are called as it is a refrain. Okay, so here I will give you the definition of refrain. What it is? It is the repetition of a line in a stanza. It is a repetition of a line in a stanza to create a rhyming or musical effect. Okay, so why they are using this? Why the line is repeating to the last end of the paragraph? Because so to create a rhyming effect, which is gives the musical effect. Okay, so when we can see in some of the songs that some lines are repeating again and again because it gives a musical effect to that one. So that's why the lines are repeated, and in this poem also these lines are repeated in the first stanza and second stanza, and not repeated in the third stanza. So those two stanzas are followed with the poetic device technique is called as a refrain. And refrain is mean, it means it is a repetition of a line in a stanza to create a rhyming or effect. Sorry, I have written effect two times. That is music effect. Music effect. Rhyming or music effect. That gives a rhyming or music effect. This is called as a poetic device. Okay. So this is about, and this poet has written in a simple language. It is not in a complicated language which is not to understand. Okay. So it is written in a very simple language. It's easy to understand it. Okay. So this is about a poem. Now I'm going to move to the questions of this poem. Here some of the few questions are given here in the textbook after the end of the poem. So what are the questions? Let's see here. Working with the poem. So with the helping of that poem, when because we have understood about what is a poem, okay, and what are the intention behind in that poem and what is the deep meaning in that poem. Okay, so let's see. Find three or four phrases in stanzas 1 and 2 which are likely to occur in geography lesson. Okay, so it's your homework. Okay, so you have to do in this class only. So in this class you have to do that. Okay, so you have to find out, so which are the geographical word which is present in this poem. So which is present in a 3-4 phrases in the stanza 1 and 2. So both in stanza first and second, so which are the geographical words are there? Geographical words means the words which is using in geography also, geography subject also. Okay, so that words you have to find out from the two stanzas. The next is, seen from the window of an aeroplane, the city appears. Here are the options given: as haphazard as on ground, as neat as a map, as developed as necessary. Mark the right answer. So this is left to you. So you have to mark the right answer because you know the poem very well. So you have to find out the right answer. So from the window of an aeroplane. So when he looks from the, when the poet has looks from the aeroplane, so how the city looks, how it appears. Okay. Then next is, which of the following statements are example of the logic of geography? Okay. Here have some of the options. So you can mark more than one, more than two or three. If you feel that, if you, because you know the poem now, you have understood the poem. So if you have more than one answer, you can mark it. More than two answer, then you can mark it. Options, okay? So the options which is related to that question, you can mark 1, 2 or 3, okay? So this is, here the options are, there are cities where there are rivers, okay? So which is example for the logic of geography. Cities appear as they are not from 6 miles above the ground. It is easy to understand why valleys are populated. Then it is difficult to understand why humans hate and kill one another. The earth is round and it has more sea than land. So in these options, so answers may be more than one or two. So you can write the answer, mark the answer. Next is, mention two things that are clear from the height, not clear from the height. So here the poet says that, so clear from the height. So what is clear? The geographical location. So when the poet sees from the high, so it looks different. So which is clear, okay? Which is clear from the height. Means according to the plan, according to the map, so the cities are constructed very well, okay? Like a geometric design. But something is not clear. What is not clear? Not clear from the height. That the hatredness among the people, okay, the hatredness, the wars and the killing, during the wars, the killing of the people and the battles. So that he has not understood it. That is not clear. So why the people are having the hatredness to each other and also they are having the wars and also the battles. So why they do the wars and battles? So this is the, this is about a poem and the poet, and this is the theme of the poem and I have explained. So I hope that all are understood it very well. So you had enjoyed it, this geography lesson, and whatever I have given the work, do that work. Okay, so all of you stay at home, keep learning. Okay, So all of you, thank you.